generate irresistible scarcity of you. One of the more famous characters from Seinfeld is the soup Nazi. Dude has some seriously delicious soup. His soup was so popular, he didn't need to advertise. Tons of people came for his delicious soup only because of word of mouth. And because he always had tons of customers, he could demand whatever behavior he wanted. When you are waiting in line to order your soup, if you asked the wrong question or even said the wrong thing, the soup Nazi would scream at you, "No soup for you," and you'd get kicked out. On the other hand, think of a kid who is desperate to be your friend. They'll do anything. Often these kids get taken advantage of by the other kids. This is a common movie and TV trope. A character isn't one of the cool kids, but he lives in a nice place, has a nice house, and his parents have nice cars. So the cool kids pretend to like him just so they can get access to his stuff. The general character arc is the kid thinks he's finally arrived. He starts to believe he's finally been accepted into the cool kids. But then something happens and they all ditch him. He ends up feeling manipulated and heartbroken. There are two sides of this same spectrum. One, the soup Nazi has something in very high demand, so he can't afford to qualify his customers in the extreme. On the other hand, you have the kid who is so desperate to be anybody's friend, everybody can see it, and everybody but him can tell he's being manipulated by the cool kids. This is a function of scarcity. The soup Nazi feels zero scarcity. From inside his brain, he sees nothing but long lines of customers. So he radiates scarcity. Scarcity of his approval. Scarcity of his soup. On the other hand, the begging for friends kid has the opposite. He feels scarcity. So what he offers is abundantly given to anybody and everybody. Please accept me, somebody. While purely fictional and comedic, the soup Nazi doesn't need to do squat. His scarcity does all the work for him. But the begging for friends kid is unfortunately much more realistic. But the secret is that scarcity is an inside game. The kid decides that he needs friends. And since he doesn't have friends, that makes him desperate. Outer scarcity of you doesn't require you create world-famous soup. It requires you first choose who is lucky enough to get your two most precious resources, your time and your attention. The more you focus your time and attention on the building of you, the more scarce and in demand you will be. And people will be lining up and hoping to get some of you. To learn how, visit mindpersuasion.com/scarcity-generator.